Hello students, now we will see the topic called packet switching. So what is a switching? Switching is a device capable of creating a temporary connection between two devices. So when we want to establish a temporary connection between the two devices, we can go for switching. So switching is divided into three types. One is circuit switching, packet switching and message switching. So in the last video, we have already seen circuit switching. So in this, we are going to discuss on packet switching. So in this packet switching here, when we want to communicate, when a device A wants to communicate with device B, so here they can use packet, in between data link layer and network layer, they will use packet switched network for communication. So here what happens is the message will be divided into packets. So the packets, they will be divided into packets and they'll be sent. So here in the destination side, the packets will be rearranged and then it will create the whole message. So here packets, the messages will be divided into messages or divided into packets. And it is delivered to the destination. So there are two types of packet switching. So the method which they follow for delivering it to the destination is, they follow two approaches. One is virtual circuit approach. Second one is datagram approach. So coming to this virtual circuit approach and datagram approach, first I will tell you the difference between virtual circuit and datagram approach. Then we will see in detail about datagram approach. Then we will go for virtual circuit approach. Coming to virtual circuit approach, so here you can see there are six switches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are switches, six switches which are connecting the end system. So here you can see the end system A and this is end system B and this is end system C. So in virtual circuit approach, what happens is, so here a pre-planned route will be established between the end system. Suppose if A wants to communicate with B, it will follow this particular path. And if A wants to communicate with C, it follows this particular path to reach C. So a pre-planned route is established between A and B. After establishing the route, the packets will follow the same route and it will reach the destination. This is what we have your virtual circuit. So one route will be established. After establishing the route, then we will be sending the packets. All the packets will follow the same route. But in case of datagram approach, what happens is, the same example we have taken. So we have six switches over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are all switches and we have end system A, B and C or end system. Suppose if A wants to communicate with B and it is forming a packets like 1, 2, 3 packets, message is divided into 3 packets, and if this packets has to be reached to B, so what happens is that here this packet 1 and 2 will follow this particular path, 1, 2, 3, it goes to B. But the packet 3, it follows this path, 1, 4, it goes to 3 and then it reaches B. So every packet will follow their own path and it reaches the destination B. In the destination, they have to rearrange the packets and there are some chances of missing some of the packets. So the destination has to take the responsibility for rearranging the packet and to recover the missed packet also. This approach is called as datagram approach. So in datagram approach, all the packets will not follow the same path. Each packet will follow their own path and it reaches the destination. So there are two types of packet switching. One is virtual circuit and datagram approach. So coming to virtual circuit, one pre-planned route will be established and they will be sending all the packets. Suppose here the packet is that, they will form the same path. But in case of datagram approach, it is not like that. All the packets will follow different path. So here B represent the destination and 2, 1 represent the numbers in the packet. Suppose the 1 and 2 is passing through this, and third packet alone it is passing through this particular path. In detail about datagram networks. Here in datagram networks, each packet is treated independently. Each packet is treated independently. Here the packets are called as datagrams. Here the packets are called as datagrams and they are treated independently. You will see the example for this. So you can see the end system over here, A, and you have some other end system, and you have an end system called X. So here we have five switches. So this network is having 5 switches with 4 end system with 5 switches. So when a device A wants to communicate with device X, so it is forming a packet. It is divided into packets will be divided into datagrams. It is called as datagrams here. So it is divided into 4 packets, 1, 2, 3, 4. So when it arrives to the switch X, third packet and one packet, 3 and 1 will follow this particular path. It reaches here and 1 will follow here, and then it comes to this switch and it reaches here. So fourth packet, it comes here directly, it comes to switch 3 and it comes here. Now the second packet will comes to from, it will moves from switch 1 to switch 4, and from there it goes to switch 3, and again all the packets will arrive to the destination. So what happens is all the packets will be, each packet will be treated independently. Second is, the packets, they can take their own practical path. It is not that they have to follow the same path. So each packet, they can follow their own path. May take any route. And third is, packets may arrive out of order. So here the packets we have arranged in 1, 2, 3, 4. But here we will not be arrive. We will not be receiving the packets in the same order. So the third point is that the packets may arrive out of order. And fourth is, some of the packets may get lost or delayed. Some packets may get lost or delayed. And fifth one is, it is up to the receiver to recover the packets. Suppose some of the packets have been lost in between the networks, it is a responsibility for the receiver to reorder the packets and recover the missing one. So it is up to the receiver to reorder the packet and recover the missing ones. So this is the approach for your datagram network. In datagram network, all the packets will be treated independently and they can follow their own path to reach the destination. Here in this example, the packet 1 and 3 is following the path switch 1, 2, and again the switch 1, it reaches switch 5, and from there it goes to switch 3, and switch 3, this packet 3, it goes directly to switch 3. So likewise, every packet will follow their own path. And third is, they can come out of order also. They will not be in the same order as it has been sent. So the next, the last packet, this receiver has to take care of rearranging the packets and relocating the packets. That is the responsibility for the receiver. That's all about their datagram approach. Now we will see the routing table of datagram approach. So coming to the routing table, so here every switch will maintain the routing table. So here this is the port. So routing table contains two information. One is destination address and the port. So in this, suppose destination B, it can be connected to the port 2. Destination C can be connected with port 1. Example like this, every switch will be maintaining this routing table. So when we need to transmit the message or a packet, it will go, the switch will go and search in the routing table and it will route the packets. Next we will see the efficiency. So coming to the efficiency, so when we compare the efficiency of circuit switched network with this datagram approach, this efficiency is better. Because in case of circuit switched network, first we need to establish the connection, then we will be sending the packets. But here, resources are allocated. Only when there are packets to be transferred. So when we need to transfer the packets, then only the packets resources will be allocated. But in case of circuit switched network, when we need to establish the connection, the resources will be allocated from the point of establishing the connection to the end of the connection. The resources will be allocated to the particular two stations alone. But in case of this datagram approach, only when the packets to be transmitted, that resources will be allocated. So the efficiency is greater when compared with circuit switched network. Now we will see the delay in datagram network. So coming to the delay, so here consider this is the source A, and we have in between we have two switches, and this is source B. So to find out the delay, so here it is A will transmit the message. From there, here it has to wait for some time to look. This switch has to go and search in the routing table. And again, it will wait. It will transmit the message to the packet to the switch 2. And from there, again, it will go and search in the routing table. And from there, the message will be transmitted to the destination B. So what happens is, this is the transmission time of the message. And this is the waiting time inside the switch 1, and this is the waiting time in switch 2. So the delay, total delay will be, this is the total delay. So we will find the total delay as 3 times the transmission time. So 3 transmission time plus 3 times the propagation delay. Propagation delay is a delay between the two between the source and the switch, and also from the switch to switch and from switch to this end. So we have 3 propagation delay plus waiting time 1. This is the waiting time inside the switch 1, and waiting time 2, this is the waiting time inside the switch 2. So the delay will be, total delay in case of your datagram approach will be 3 times the transmission time plus 3 times propagation delay plus waiting time 1 plus waiting time 2. We can, using this formula, we can find out the delay of this particular datagram approach. Okay, so in datagram approach, we have learned the basic diagram of datagram approach, and we have learned how to communicate, how to send the packets inside the datagram approach, and using the routing table, they will be maintaining the information about all the addresses, and we have seen the efficiency, and last we have seen the delay in datagram approach.